Wombat Stew, written by Marcia K. Vaughan and illustrated by Pamela Lofts. One day, on the banks of a billabong, a very clever dingo caught a wombat and decided to make Wombat Stew, Wombat Stew, gooey, brewy, yummy, chewy Wombat Stew. Platypus came ambling up the bank. "Good day, Dingo," he said, snapping his bill. "What's all that water for?" "I'm brewing up a gooey, chewy stew with that fat wombat," replied Dingo with a toothy grin. Here comes the platypus. "If you ask me," said Platypus, "the best thing for a gooey stew is mud. Big blocks of billabong mud." "Lots of mud?" Dingo laughed. "What a good idea." "Righto, in they go." So Platypus scooped up big blobs of mud with his tail and tipped them into the billy can.
"Finish billy can? Who knows what a billy can is?"
Around the bubbling billy, Dingo danced and sang, "Wombat stew, wombat stew, gooey, brewy, yummy, chewy, wombat stew." Waltzing out from the shade of the ironbark came Amy. She arched her graceful neck over the brew. "Oh, Dingo," she fluttered, "what have we here?"
"Gooey, chewy wombat stew," boasted Dingo.
"If only it were a bit more chewy," she sighed. "But don't worry, a few feathers will set it right."
"Feathers?" Dingo smiled. "That will be chewy."
"Righto, in they go." So into the gooey brew, Amy dropped her finest feathers. Around and around the bubbling billy, Dingo danced and sang, "Wombat stew, wombat stew, crunchy munchy for my lunchy wombat stew."
Old Blue Tongue the Lizard came sliding off his sun-soaked stone.
"Silly Dingo," he hissed. "There are no flies in this stew. Can't be wombat stew without crunchy flies in it." And he stuck out his bright blue tongue.
Look at all the flies he's catching with that tongue.
"There's a lot to be said for flies," agreed Dingo, rubbing his paws together. "Righto, in they go." So Lizard snapped 100 flies from the air with his long tongue and flipped them into the gooey stew. Around and around and around the bubbling billy, Dingo danced and sang, "Wombat stew, wombat stew, crunchy munchy for my lunchy wombat stew."
The stew bubbling away in the billy.
Up through the red dust popped Echidna.
"Here he is."
"Wait a bit, not so fast," he bristled, shaking the red dust from his quills.
"What are quills?" "Can you see the quills and Echidna has quills?"
"Now I've been listening to all this advice, and take it from me, for a munchy stew you need slugs and bugs and creepy crawlies."
"Ooh."
Dingo wagged his tail. "Why, I should have thought of that." "Righto, in they go." So Echidna dug up all sorts of creepy crawlies and dropped them into the gooey, chewy, crunchy stew.
Can you see those creepy crawlies?
The very clever Dingo stirred and stirred all the while singing, wombat stew, hot and spicy, oh so nicey, wombat stew. Just then, the sleepy-eyed koala climbed down the scribbly gum tree.
"Look here," he yawned. "Any bush cook knows you can't make a spicy stew without gum nuts."
Leave it to a koala to think of gum nuts, Dingo laughed and licked his whiskers. Righto, in they go. And into the gooey, chewy, crunchy, munchy stew, koala shook lots and lots of gum nuts. Aha, cried Dingo. Now my stew is missing only one thing. What's that? Asked the animal.
That. Wombat.
What's going to happen to the wombat, do you think?
Wait, stop! Hang on, Dingo. You can't put that wombat into the stew yet.
Why not?
You haven't tasted it.
Righto, I'll taste it. What does it look like happened?
The very clever Dingo bent over the billy and took a great big slurp of stew.
Oh, gooey! I'm poisoned, he howled. You've all tricked me.
And he dashed away deep into the bush, never to be seen again. And never, ever to sing Wombat Stew, Wombat Stew, gooey, brewy, yummy, chewy, Wombat Stew.